everyone. Welcome in. It is 10 p.m. Central Time on Thursday, August 4th, 2016. And let me turn my volume up. Okay, maybe that might be a little bit better. That was really low. Hope you guys are doing good. We're here on the Earthquake 3D live stream, looking at the last 24 hours of earthquakes that struck since my update last night at 10 p.m. In case you missed it last night, we had a few interesting earthquakes we were talking about. And we were talking about the West Coast. We were also talking about activity striking around on the West Pacific. And as I'm talking here, if you hear dings or rumbles, those are new earthquakes which are striking. And in that case, that was two different 3.0 earthquakes striking at the same time, one in the far west over in Europe and one on the West Coast. So just be aware that's going on right now as I'm talking. But last night's update was pretty interesting. We were talking about areas to watch. We were talking about over in Japan. And Japan wasn't struck, but the Izu Ridge was struck by a very deep 6.2. And as we know, from deep earthquakes, we need to watch for shallower, larger movement, either swarms or a single larger earthquake release. And because we have a silent zone to the north, right across Japan, the central point of the silent zone takes us down into the zone that was just warned for that fake 9.1 earthquake in central Japan right along the coast. And we have to watch for 1 to 2 magnitudes larger or an equivalent swarm to spread out across the area. So like this past week, 7.7 that struck, that sent all the fives down to the south, this time we have to watch for possible swarm of fives to the north or a single larger earthquake. Now on the west coast of the US, check it out. Several different 4.0 earthquakes struck at the California-Nevada border. And this is really interesting to see because last night we were talking about watching for movement off the coast and how all these swarms had developed out in Northern California. Well, take a look at this swarm. Look at this. And if we go look up the location, you're going to find out that there's multiple volcanoes nearby this spot. And the location is called Janesville, California, or at least the location listed by the USGS is 30 kilometers east-southeast of Janesville. But I'd like to just go ahead and open up a copy of Google Earth, and we'll take coordinates from the USGS. Okay, that's really weird. Every time I'm trying to do a display capture, it's turning on my intro. That's YouTube, guys. Hold on. Well, we're just not going to allow a display capture tonight. Is that what's going on here? Hold on. Okay, I will show you. I mean, we're not going to stop. So no matter what anybody does to try and stop it or what technical error is going to occur, we're going to keep trucking. Here's the coordinates. Hopefully you guys can see this. You know, it's telling me that it's not screen sharing, but I'm seeing it on my screen, so I don't know. It was, it wasn't, it was. I'll have to take a chance that it is. So here's our 4.0 swarm location. And it's happening right below a large Army ammunition depot, the Sierra Army Depot. And these are bunkers filled with ammunition. And when we see an earthquake striking here, some people might say, oh, well, that could be, you know, an explosion. Well, it's happening several kilometers below the surface. And it's happening right next to Lassen Volcanic Center. So here's Lassen, and we have dozens, if not more, volcanic cones extending far over to the east, and many of them are really impressive. I mean, you can still even make out that they're volcanoes, some being mined, others being fracked, actually, believe it or not, or injected with water for steam purposes, geothermal. And then over to the east, right below the Army Depot, we have the earthquake. But to the south, at the range right here, we have multiple other volcanoes, so like Sugar Loaf. Even though this isn't marked as a volcano, it is. It's an ancient volcano. And I'm sure there's probably some information on it somewhere, but it's just not marked by the USGS. And there's many more all over the area. For every one that's marked here, there's at least 10 or 20 that aren't. And that's no exaggeration number-wise. So that's where the swarm is striking. And that's pretty darn interesting. If you ask me, when we take a look at the activity striking in Northern California, we watch for movement off the coast, and then due east of that spot is the spot to be hit. Well, what does this mean? This means there's greater pressure building off the west coast right now. I mean, the stack of earthquakes that's here tells us that there's still pressure coming from the northwest, pushing to the southeast, causing additional earthquakes all the way down throughout California, going down to Mono Lake. And Mono Lake is a supervolcano where the other stack of earthquakes are, down to the south of the Big Rings. So, the only other area that's swarming right now is the geothermal pumping operation still at Geysers or Clear Lake Volcano. And down to the south, I don't even know if you want to call this a swarm, but this has started well over two months ago with a 5.2 earthquake and thousands of other earthquakes. Now the swarm to the northeast continues to grow. And this spot is called Thermal California for its geothermal pumping operations, where they're injecting water down into the volcano there. So a new swarm there? Now check it out. Look down to the south. See the 3.2? This is really interesting because just down to the south, let's show you what's south of the border where the 3.2 struck. Ironically, I showed this to you guys last night in the update. Cerro Prieto, or Cerro Prieto. Regardless how you pronounce it, it is an old volcanic butte. We have a crater, and in the crater, we have graffiti written by locals. That'll help you to remember this volcano among all the others. So, again, right there, 3.2, swarm striking there. It's no shock because the magma chambers are being displaced. And all the magma chambers are being displaced all the way down to Mono Lake at the eastern California border with Nevada, all the way north to a new swarm at Yellowstone. And you guys may remember me talking about Yellowstone last night, that we would see a new swarm strike at Yellowstone as a result of these four striking, and now it has occurred. Additionally, pressure transfer to the east and the fracking operations were hit by a new slight round of earthquakes. We're going to see more off this. There's no doubt about that over the next several weeks. Again, several weeks, we're going to see new swarms develop out here in the Midwest. Why weeks? Well, with this kind of activity developing off the West Coast, and with the silence that picked up over the past few days in the Midwest, this lets me know we're going to see more than just a few smaller earthquakes develop out in the Midwest, and that'll be followed by a superfracture. Once anything over a 4 strikes, that then leads into another week's worth of earthquakes. So don't kid yourself. If you see the silence there, you'll know the silence is going to build into a new round of earthquakes to strike in the Midwest very soon. So off the coast, we're still watching, and we're not going to let up the watch until it strikes. So it's going to strike. It's a silent zone. It's building. Either that or they didn't report the earthquake this past week, which we've seen them do. Not report earthquakes off the West Coast in the 4 to 5 range. Just ignore them. So maybe they did that, or we're still waiting and looking for that to strike. Something's pushing all of California right now. All right? And internationally speaking, well, our areas to the west, we talked about it over in Japan. Look at the spot that was struck to the south. If you watched my update last night, where did I tell you to watch for the largest earthquake to strike? You may remember, I said eastern Papua New Guinea going into Solomon Islands, next spot to show movement, and it was hit just as expected. Now, over here in South America, look what happened just south of the Bolivia border in Argentina. A 6.1, fairly deep. But this follows the deep fours. I talked about it last night. Deep fours leading to shallow fives or sixes, and I don't know if it's deeper or less, but a six struck right in the spot where we were expecting to see additional movement strike at the bend in Chile. Furthermore, we saw Peru get struck late last night, which it's not on the map here now. I'd like to get into the European earthquakes just to run over what struck over the past day. This really isn't incorporating much of a forecast into, this is the last 7 days of earthquakes. Check it out real quick. Just take a look at it. I mean, it's a lot of activity. Again, the second week in a row where we have a lot of activity after 7 days' time. But take a look at it. Here's all the 50 earthquakes from the EMSC, and you'll see a swarm has broken out here near Kajikistan and Turkmenistan. And we were talking about near Afghanistan, so this is right off from Afghanistan. No, just a 100 miles maybe 150 miles. So not far, and it's a large swarm. To accompany that, South Europe started moving again with twos and threes, just popping off every few minutes today, right guys? Every few minutes it was like ding, 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 all these twos hits and threes. Then we saw activity spread over all the way across South Europe, and because you can't see it here right now, just because it's the last 50 earthquakes, there was another earthquake at the Swiss border with Italy. Or I'm sorry, at the Swiss border with Germany. North, I guess, right? Okay. Anyways, in that location, we saw new movement, but we have not seen the activity strike the English Channel across UK into Scotland yet. We have to watch for it. It's going to hit. It's transferring to the west. It's got to transfer to the northwest. Iceland, tremendously quiet. No movement along the North Mid-Atlantic Ridge at all. Over the last week, nothing. And we would expect to see it after that 4 and the 5 struck in South Europe, but nothing. So that's building, and it will release in the next few days. Whether it's a swarm or a single larger earthquake, the earthquake should only be in the 2 to 3 range, striking across the UK. I mean, I'm not looking for a major earthquake to strike, but it'll be noteworthy. It'll be the larger of the bunch. And then Mid-Atlantic Ridge, 4s should strike along the Mid-Atlantic south of Iceland. Sooner or later here, very soon. And where else on the planet do we have? I mean, Central America, we could talk about Central America really quick. Let's just run over the earthquakes in Central America. Now, you may remember we talked about Costa Rica. And let's see, where did this earthquake strike? Let's go verify on that. Nicaragua. Okay, it is right even with the Costa Rica border. So you can maybe hopefully see on the screen the Costa Rica border. Oh, you guys haven't seen a thing I'm doing, have you? Have you? Or have you? Hold on. Hopefully you've seen everything I've been doing. My God, I hope you've seen it. Every time I was clicking over, it was showing a white screen. That's crazy. See, I got problems going on here tonight, guys. I've had technical issues all day. So Costa Rica, all right, here's the border. And to the west, right there, that's the spot which was struck. So, overall, what can I say? Our activity where we were watching for did strike in the areas which we were expecting. West Coast struck, but not out to sea. So that means that area is still building. But a noteworthy swarm of fours, what can I say, followed by a swarm of threes in the Midwest? Just as expected. Over in Asia, deep six, meaning shallow larger earthquake or swarm coming. And in Asia, going west, we have our swarm spot giving way as expected. You see a silent zone now extending from Nepal all the way down to Sumatra. And that puts us in the middle down into Myanmar again. That's possibly a new spot where we might have to watch for additional movement. But the movement we'll have to watch for will only be in the 5 range because of the swarm and cluster to the east, southeast, all the 4s, upper 4s. And all the 4s and upper 4s to the west, northwest. Combine the two, that'll take you into 1-5. Mid-5 at the most. Right in the middle. So, right in the middle puts us South Myanmar. Okay? So, word up to all my people. That's the update. I don't have much to go on tonight. Just letting you know what's going down. You know, guys, this is why I do what I do. And, you know what? I don't know how to turn this off now. This is crazy. Now it won't turn off. Well, maybe it did, maybe it didn't. I don't know. That's the way it goes with a live stream. So I'm not going to be saving this to my channel. I don't know if you guys are even going to want to get it out because of all the technical errors tonight. But that's the update for tonight. Please get the word out and let everybody know we're still watching for movement off the West Coast and the movement transferring east from the West Coast. This includes the East Coast, but I'm not going to even bother trying to tell the people on the East Coast. They don't need to know, do they? Do the people on the East Coast need to know about when an earthquake's going to strike? I don't know. Maybe they do, maybe they don't. If they want to know, I guess they can contact me and tell me the, you know, I'm not going to waste your time, guys. All right? So, word up. Have a good night. I'll be back later. Cheers.